So, let's start with this picture. Here I have shown you some pictures. First picture is of zebra. Can you see a pattern on the body of the zebra? There is some strips made on the body of zebra. One strip is of white color, another is black, then again white, then black. So you can see a pattern of strips, white and black strips. Same way, now let's come to the another picture. That is the picture of peacock. You all know peacock. Peacock is our national bird. And its wings are very beautiful. That's why it has been taken for our national bird. What is the beauty in the wings? Can you see? There are patches of color on the wings of peacock. And in each and every patch, the pattern of color is same. It has started from navy blue color, then light blue color, then brown, then green, and then wings. So, every patch has the same pattern of color. So, you can see a beautiful pattern on the wings of peacock. Now, let's come to the another picture. This is the picture of honeycomb. It is honeybee store its honey in this honeycomb. Can you see a similar type of shape is all over the honeycomb? You can see a pattern that each and every hole is of hexagonal shape. Let's move on to the next pattern. So, this is the shape pattern. Can you see what I have done here? Yes, I have drawn arrows, but I have done something different in this arrows. There is a pattern of continuity, and then coming to the next, that is, I have drawn a circle, and in that circle I have drawn a triangle, and in the next box what I have done, again a circle, but in this case I have tilted the triangle, I have inverted the triangle, and then next picture there is again a circle, but in this case the triangle is in upward direction. So this is called your repeated pattern. Now let's move on to numbers. Can you see in this picture I have written some numbers. How I have written? First I have written 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9, then 11. So what I have done, I have added every time 2. 1 plus 2, your 3, 3 plus 2, your 5, 5 plus 2, your 7, and then 7 plus 2, your 9. So this type of pattern called growing patterns. And then coming to the next, that is your 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Here also I have added 2, then we get 4. And when I added 2 to 4, then I got 6. In this way, this is also growing. This is also increasing manner. Nowhere the number is getting decreased from the previous number. Every next number is more than the previous number. So this is your growing pattern. And also because we have used numbers here, so we can call it number pattern also. Now let's learn something different from this. I have a story for you. There is a boy whose name is T2 and he has a block. This is the block of T2. Now he wants to do some creative things. So he thought, let me print my mother's sari. So he used this block, put it into the color and started printing his mother's sari. Now how he has printed? You can see this type of pattern he has created on his mother's sari. He put it the block first in upward direction, then for the border upward direction, and for the middle thing what he has done, he had put it the block in two different directions. Can you see? Just by using one single block, he is able to create a new beautiful design, which is little bit different from block. Similar, but giving a different appearance. Now, after making the sari, he thought, let me do some creativity in another cloth. Let's see what type of cloth he has chosen. Oh, this time he has chosen dupatta of his sister. He had put it 4 blocks at one place. So in this way, By creating this new design, he has printed her sister's dupatta, and it is really looking so beautiful. And this Titu is a naughty boy. So what he has done? He tried this with bedsheet also. In the case of bedsheet, he has done something different. What he has done? In first line, he has put the blocks in upward direction, and then in the second line in the downward direction. In this way again he has created a different pattern. So can you see, with one single block he is able to create three different type of patterns. Now it's your turn to rack your brain, and with the help of blocks you can create different types of patterns, and this will give you really lots of pleasure. In this we have increasing the leaf one by one. In first box I am having one leaf, in second box I am having two leaves, third three, and then fourth four leaves, and then in the fifth again one leaf. So what is happening here? In the first four blocks leaves is increasing, but in the fifth block what has happened? Again one leaf has came. So repetition has done. So in this pattern both the things are there. Repetition is also there, and then increasing of leaves are also there. So you can call it growing pattern. Now start from looking first line 1 2 3, next line 3 1 2, then 2 3 1. In this way here 1 3 2, then 2 1 3, and then 3 2 1. So in every line no number is repeating. So this is the pattern in this figure. And can you see there are two types of line? Do you know the name of these lines? These horizontal lines, these lines are called rows, and these vertical lines, or you can say standing line, its name is column. So two new words you have again learned, one row, another column. Now can you try this type of pattern? Can you try, can you make this type of pattern with letters ABC? But the rule is the same, that no letter comes twice in any line. So in every line all the letters should be different. So you can try it out at your home and enjoy making your own patterns. Here I have used some digits. You have to put all these numbers on the sides of the triangle, and you have to follow one more rule, that is numbers on each side of the triangle add up to 9, means the numbers written on the sides of the triangle, when you will add up those numbers then the sum up should be equal to 9. Let's draw a triangle first. Let's start putting circles on the triangles. So I have started from the corner. I have put one circle on the corner, then next circle in the middle, and then another circle on this side, and then another circle on this corner, and then again one more circle in the middle, and then in the last one more circle in the corner. Now I have taken the digit 1. Now 1 is the smallest one, so let's take the bigger one. So I have taken the digit 6. So 1 plus 6, that is your 7. Now I will add 2 to this. And when I am adding 2, 7 plus 2, what is it? That is equal to your 9. So can we place all these 3 digits on one side? So that is when I will put 1, 6, 2, and then the sum up is equal to your 9. Now let's go to the other side. Let's start from 5 this time. I have taken 5, and then I will add to this 5 3. When I have added 3 to this, then you can see what has come, 8. So 1 is left. So can we add 1? If we will add 1 to 5 plus 3, then it will become 9. So 5 plus 3 plus 1 is equal to 9. So this pair of three number is again giving us the addition equals to 9. Now let's move on to the next digit. As we have not taken 4 yet, let's take 4. Now I have taken 4. Now for making 4, I need 5 more. So I have to take less than 5. So let's take 3. So 4 plus 3 is your 7. Now when it is 7, you need 2 more. Add 2 to this. When you are adding 2 to this, it has become 9. So you have got these 3 sets of 3 digits, which is giving you the sum up equal to 9. But you have to be little more careful. Why? Because you can see that one blue circle and 2 red circles are on the corner. So it is covering 2 lines, and 2 green circle and 1 blue circle is covering only 1 line. So you have to put the number in such a way which is coming twice on the corner places, and then you have to put those number in the middle which is coming only one time. I have made another triangle, and in this triangle I have put 1 to the corner, and then 2 to the this corner, and then 3 to the this corner. Now 4, 5, 6. I started from 4. I have put 4 here. 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 3, 9. Now I have put it 5 here. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 1, 9. Now come to the last one. Here I have put it 6. So 6 plus 2, 8. 8 plus 9. So have you seen that the numbers on one line is equal to 9? And here again we have one more triangle. So in this, what you have to do? You have to draw another triangle, and in this triangle you have to put again the digits from 1 to 6, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. But the rule is little bit different. Here you have to put the number on each side of the triangle. But what should be the add up? Add up should be 10, not 9. So you can try it out, and this is a challenge for you, and you will really enjoy doing this, because you have to use all your knowledge of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and then you have to put the numbers in these circles, and then you will be able to solve this puzzle. So let's enjoy with this puzzle. And I am moving to the next pattern. This is the pattern of number tower. Now what is number tower? We have seen so many towers, but nowhere we have seen number tower. So let's see, what is this number tower? In this number tower, I have used some numbers, and I have put it this number in the baseline. Whenever we build a house, we make a base. Same way, we have put it this number in the baseline. Now what next? We have to add up. Add up these two base. 10 plus 20 is equals to 30. So I have put it 30 on this. Now add 20 plus 30. What will be the answer? 50. So it has came here. Now you have to add 30 plus 40. What will come? 70. So here is your 70. Now you have to add up 40 plus 50. What will be the next? That will be your 90. Now same process, you have to do it again for 30 plus 50. Again you have to add 30 and 50, that is 80. Then you have to add 50 and 70. What will you get? When you will add 50 and 70? 120. Now what you have to do? You have to add 70 plus 90, that will be your 160. Now 3 boxes are there. How many boxes will come? 2 boxes will come on this. Now when you will add 80 plus 120, that is your 200. And when you will add 120 plus 160, your answer will be 280. And now only one box. So that is 200 plus 280, that is your 480. So can you see? Is it looking like tower? Yes. But here we have made this tower with the help of number. Every time what we are doing? We are adding the base number. and then making one brick above those two base bricks by using the addition of that number. So let's do it by yourself. I have also made a tower for you, number tower for you, but I have not solved it. Now it's your turn to solve it. Use your brain and try to solve it. When you will try to solve it, you have to think of that what can be added to this so that I can get this number, how much I should need it to make this number up to this number. Let's see what is there in my box. Yes, this number tower is there for you. Now, I have written some numbers and some numbers I have not written. You have to find it out. I have written 5 and then next I have left blank. Then I have written 15 and then 20, and in the above I have only written 25. Now you have to fill up all these. Just think of that, how this number tower has been built by adding the base towers. So when you will add the base tower, then the above tower will come. So you can try it, you can find it out. Just think of that, how can I reach out to 25? What will I add to 15 to make it 25? When you will think in this way, you will get the answer that what will come in between 15 and 5. Just think it off and then move ahead. And I'm sure you will be able to do it. Don't bother that how will it happen. Just start thinking. When you will start thinking, you will start recalling all those numbers which you have done earlier also. You have done many times additions. Just you have to recall those additions and you have to put it in this number tower and you will be able to build up this number tower. And then you can create your own tower and give a challenge to your friend, your mother, your father, and let's see they are able to do it or not. And you will be having a fun that yes, you have created a tower and how they are solving. And if they are not able to solve, then you will be a genius and telling to them that this is the answer. You are not able to do it, but I am able to do it. So let's become the genius. Now moving on to next thing. Here I have used alphabets for making the pattern. I have written ABC in first oval shape, then DEF in second, then GHI. And next 3 oval shapes I have left for you. You have to fill it. What will come next? 2 things I have told. That first thing you have to observe that this is a growing pattern, repetition of pattern, or what type of thing we have used. Here what we have used? We have used alphabet. So you have to be minutely think that how can I take this pattern ahead? How can I complete this pattern? So try to observe the rule of this pattern and you will be able to finish it up. Now next, moving to the next pattern. Here I have mixed the number also with alphabet. Here you have to use numbers also and alphabets also. And when you will add on both the things, then you will be able to finish up this pattern also. Numbers are in increasing order, but can you see the alphabet? It is not in increasing order, it is going backward. So think it and try to finish up this pattern. And then in the next pattern, I have given some numbers. And in this, I have added something somewhere. And then you have to complete this pattern. And in the next pattern, 9, 109, 209. Now you have to think what will come next. So can you see there are 4 types of pattern, one with alphabets, another with number and alphabet, then 864, 764, 664. What is happening? It is going in reverse direction. Number is decreasing every time, but by how much it is decreasing, that you have to find it out. Then in the next, 9, 109, 209, what is happening? It is increasing, but by how much? Just find it out and try to complete these patterns. I am sure you will be able to do it. And one more work is for you. What is the work? Here you have to make your own patterns by using number. I have made pattern for you. For example, 9, 1 and 9, 209. In this way, you can also create your pattern. Then next question is very important for you. This is about our surrounding. What you have to do? You have to observe the pattern. Patterns around you. There are so many patterns in our nature. As I have shown, pattern on the zebra, pattern on the peacock, pattern in the honeybee comb. So try to find out all these patterns. The petals of the flower, there is a pattern there also. Try to observe birds, animals. You will see lot of pattern in the nature. Just try to observe. So it's a beautiful chance to really understand that what nature is giving us. Just go and look it and try to collect patterns from the nature and make your own scrapbook and paste all the patterns in that. Now coming to the next, that is your patterns without numbers. Now how will you make pattern without numbers? There are so many shapes are there. I have shown you one pattern of circle, there was no number, but there is a pattern, and pattern where rotation takes place. So students, today we have learned about patterns. So let's do it at your home and try to observe patterns. And again we will meet next time, then again we will learn more about pattern and more about the rules of pattern, magic squares, many things are there. I will tell you all those things. Thank you.